Hey, what's going on guys? This is Amir Hussain and you are watching Trick I Know YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to show you a mid-range CPU cooler. It's a Corsair H100 RGB liquid cooler. Actually, it's a AIO all-in-one cooler. In this video, I am going to show you how exactly you can install it in your build. And in the end of the video, I will give my review as well. So without wasting any time, let's dive into the video. So guys, here is our Corsair H100 RGB liquid cooler. Now I'm going to do a quick unboxing to see what's inside the box. So here we found a QR code to get technical assistance from Corsair support. Next we have safety and warranty guide. And here we have a pouch with lots of mounting and screws. Now next we have a pouch of silica gel and wait, what is written here? Do not eat. Next we have a pair of 120mm E-Lite RGB fans. Here how it looks. It looks decent and made of hard plastic. And here are the ARGB connectors. Now next we have our CPU cooler. Let me open it up. So here is the CPU mount with a decent Corsair logo, and in the behind it have pre-applied thermal paste. And here is our radiator guys. It's a 240mm radiator. The body is made up of aluminium and the cold plate material is made of copper, and it seems I'm holding a heavy material. So guys, all these things we got in the box. There is nothing more in the box. Let's throw it out. Now guys, let's see how to set up this AIO cooler. First, we got lots of screws and mountings, which is very confusing. Let me clear it for you. So we are going to install this AIO on this Intel motherboard. This is Asus Maximus Hero 13 with an Intel i9 11th gen CPU. With the AIO cooler, we got these two mountings. The left one is for Intel motherboards and the right one for the AMD. So you have to pick the Intel one, and if you see in the back, this is 115X socket. Now come to the screws. The left side there are two Intel screws and the right one is for AMD. So we don't need AMD one. And in between these, as you know, we have LGA115X socket. So we will pick this one. The thumb screws are also need as well. These are the radiator screws, so we can mount the fans on it. This is a RGB splitter. We need this also. Fan splitter, we don't need it. Now first, we are going to set up the radiator. Take out those radiator screws and washers. Put the radiator like this. As you can see, the pipes are on the left side. Now take out the radiator fan. Make sure that the logo is at the front and the wire must be on the top side. Now simply align the fan to the radiator screw holes. Now pick a long screw with a washer and prepare it to tighten it on the fan. First, gently tighten it with your fingers. Once you applied all the screws, now double tighten them with the help of a forehead screwdriver. Now do same with the other fan, aligning it to the radiator mounting points. Put the screws gently on it and double tight it with the screwdriver. Make sure to do not over tight it, otherwise it will break your plastic fans. So we done with the radiator guys, and as you can see, the wires are on the top and the pipes are on the left side. Now we have to move to our motherboard. All you have to do, just flip your motherboard to the back side. In the back, you will see four mounting points. Now take out that provided Intel mounting, flip it up, and you will see a wrapper. Just remove that wrapper. It will allow you to stick the mounting to the motherboard. Now simply place the mounting to the motherboard like this and give a gentle push. it will stick and do not move while installing the screws from the other side. Now in this side you can see the bracket is popping out from the mounting holes. Now take out the LGA115X screws. These are just like a thumb screw. All you have to do, just tighten them on the brackets screw holes which we just installed in the back of the motherboard. Now it's time to install our pump. First remove the plastic from the back of the pump, and in the back we have pre-applied thermal paste for the CPU, and in case if it is not present here, go for the external thermal paste. Once you applied the paste, now gently put the pump on the CPU. Make sure to align with the bracket screws. Now take out the thumb screws. Now tighten it gently with your fingers. Once you've done that, double tight it with the forehead screwdriver. Now with the pump we have two wires with these connectors. The left one is the RGB connector and the right one is the power connector. If you see in the top of the motherboard, you will find a CPU fan socket. The CPU fan socket is in gray color, while the other CPU optional and chassis sockets are in the black. Now all you have to do, just connect the pump connector to the CPU socket of the motherboard, like this. Now move over to the radiator. In the radiator, we have two fans with a RGB and power connector for each fan, and we have one more RGB connector from the pump. But for now, take the power connectors from the radiator fans, then plug them to the black neighborly socket of the CPU fan. So we're done with the power connectors, and we have three RGB connectors to set up. Now take out the provided RGB splitters. This will convert your three RGB connectors to a single connector. All you need to do, just connect the all three RGB connectors like this. Once you have connected, these will look like this. Now those three RGB connectors are now converted to a single connector. Now simply plug it to the adjacent 2 socket of the motherboard and make sure you have connected to the 5V port, not the 12V port. So guys, all the connection has been done. Now you can repeat this process when you are going to install this motherboard to a PC case. So now it's time to test it out guys, and you can see everything is going nice and fine. Now we can move further to install these to the PC case. For my build, I'm using Corsair 570X RGB case. Your case may be different, but I will show you how I installed the AIO cooler. First, holding the pump, place the motherboard to the case. Tight all the motherboard screws using a forehead screwdriver. In my case, the radiator section is in the top of the case, so I will install it here. To tight it up, I will need the small screws with washers provided with the AIO cooler. Now all we have to do, just align the radiator holes to the case mounts and have to tight them with the screws. Once you do that, do a clean cable management according to your case and enjoy the AIO cooler. So that was my review and tutorial on this AIO cooler. After installing this cooler, my CPU temperature is 25 to 30 degree in normal, and it goes 45 to 50 degree when I do some rendering stuff. So if you are thinking to upgrade or wanna build a budget gaming PC, you can try this mid-range CPU cooler. So hope you enjoyed my video guys. If you really enjoyed, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe my channel for more tech videos like this. Thanks a lot for watching. See you in my next one.